Ever lost data because something crashed halfway through a database update? SQL transactions are here to protect you. In this video, I'll explain them in simple terms so you can keep your data safe and consistent, even when things go wrong. A transaction is one of the key concepts in all database management systems. Transactions allow multiple database operations to be grouped into one unit. Within a single transaction, a sequence of data operations either occurs completely or not at all. All intermediate states within a single transaction are not visible to other transactions. And if the transaction cannot be successfully completed for some reason, none of the results will be saved in the database. The easiest way to understand database transactions is through the classic example of banking transactions. Imagine we are working with a bank's database. We have a table that contains information about clients and their available balances. For simplicity, this is a table consisting of two columns, the client's name and the available balance. Let's assume we want to transfer $100 from Andrew's account to John's account. To do this, we need to perform the following operations. Reduce Andrew balance by $100 with the update command, then increase John balance by these $100. To perform such operation, we need to do two actions. It is necessary that all these actions execute together or not execute at all. A short failure isn't critical if Andrew's first attempt to transfer John's money fails, and both simply keep their original balances. However, if one operation is completed, for example, Andrew's money is deducted but John's account doesn't receive it, this leads to serious issues. In the real world, anything can happen between these two operations. A brief network outage, an error at the banking application level, or something else. We need a guarantee that if something interrupts the completion of this group of operations, none of the results of the intermediate commands will be recorded in the database, and we can get this guarantee if we combine these actions into a single transaction. In PostgreSQL, a transaction consists of a series of SQL commands between the begin and commit statements. If during a transaction we decide not to commit the changes, for example, if Andrew's balance turns negative, we can use the rollback command instead of commit, undoing all modifications. It's also important to understand how transactions interact with each other. By default, the transaction isolation level in PostgreSQL is red committed. This means that transactions only see the data that other transactions have confirmed and do not see changes made by these transactions that have not yet been confirmed. Let's look at this example in practice. I already have a table prepared with the necessary data. Let's execute a select. We see two balance records. Let's execute the transaction step by step. First, let's perform a begin. We started a transaction. Everything that will happen here in this connection is now occurring within this transaction. Let's execute the next line. Execute select. We see the intermediate result, but it is visible only within our current transaction. Let's open a parallel connection to the database and perform a select from that connection, meaning outside the scope of the current transaction. Open a new connection and execute the query. We see that here Andrew's balance is still displayed as 600, although in another open transaction we started an update and Andrew's balance has already decreased by 100. Let's go back there and continue the transaction. Perform the next update and see how the data in the table looks now. We see that John's balance increased by 100, but I repeat, we see all this only within the current transaction. If we switch to parallel connection, everything is still the same as it was before the transaction was executed. Let's go back and finally commit the transaction. Now the result is fully committed, and we will see it within parallel transactions. Let's verify this. Execute this query. Now we see the final result. Everything that happened within the transaction block wasn't visible in other database sessions until the transaction was committed. And if the transaction hadn't been committed but was rolled back, then the result of the intermediate executions wouldn't be visible. Thanks for watching. If you want to dive deeper, my complete SQL course on Udemy is available with a special offer for YouTube viewers. You'll get hands-on exercises, quizzes, and advanced tips we didn't cover here. Links in the description. And don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials.